Okay, let's get started. Let's move to the first slide. So the agenda here is really about moving your telephony to the cloud with Telstra. And as we said, we've been sending you a bunch of emails around this. So hopefully you've got the message by now. And hopefully the reason you're attending this call is because you're thinking about moving your telephony to the cloud and hopefully with Telstra. And that could be because, you know, especially during COVID, a lot of people have realized that maybe some of their old PBXs aren't up to scratch for the modern day scenarios. They don't support remote working very well, for instance. Or, you know, you need more mobile integration into your call scenario. So whatever your reason, you're thinking maybe now is the time to move from an older PBX on your premise up to something that's fully hosted and a bit more modern. And to that end, we have built the all new TIPT. Now, TIPT isn't new, right? TIPT has been around for 18 years, which is why I said there's between this group, we've got at least 15 years of experience. But the platform itself has been around 18 years. That means that most of you are using our SIP Connect services. They're on that platform, all right? And what we're talking about today is moving you to the TIPT side of things. Now, let me be really clear. That is not a separate box. This is all within the same platform. When we move you from behind a PBX and a user comes off a SIP trunk, they don't move anywhere. All we do is turn on additional features within the actual Broadworks ecosystem to give that user that cloud calling experience. And we can add on modules depending on whether they want soft clients or call center or reception, whatever it is. So that's the one thing you need to know. This platform, really stable, been around a long time, but we are not moving you. We're moving you to the cloud from where you actually are. You're already in the cloud from our SIP Connect point of view. We're just adding some features to enable you to actually turn off the PBX and run from the cloud. To that end, the migration experience is really simple and really low risk. And we've got a great customer example from the Adelaide Crows, who happened to turn up to one of our webinars like this back in August. I think it was August the 10th, actually. And we're going to talk you through what they did, and Tim will cover that part. But it's a really simple, self-service, if you want to, migration experience. We give you a tool set, you can do it yourselves. All right? Really, really simple. Low risk, by the way, because you can do one user at a time and dip your toes and actually roll it back if you don't like it. That's why it's low risk. Finally, we're going to talk about Liberate. For those of you who don't know what Liberate is, it's about integrating your mobile phones into your normal calling pattern. So integrating them into TIPT so that your mobile phones can be things like part of things like hunt groups or call centers or be call recorded or whatever. And Brad's going to talk to some of that. But it's also about enabling some APIs. And I'm going to talk about that at the end, about all of the APIs that are available on this platform that let you hook in to other business applications. So that's what we're going to talk about today. First thing I want to do, though, is first up front is show you a quick little video we created about the all-new TIPT just to get a sense of it. Away you go, Tim.
It's been estimated that 98% of all business meetings will have at least one person joining remotely. This makes cloud-based telephony essential. Introducing the all-new TIPT with Webex. So, what's new? A brand new soft client, self-service portal, and an onshore skilled support team. Easily call landlines or mobiles using your business number from within your Webex, Slack, or Microsoft Teams client. And receive calls to your business number within the Webex app, including calls made to your Telstra mobile. Organize meetings for up to 1,000 people or just chat one-to-one. You can now add, upgrade, or migrate users from old phone systems, all within minutes via the self-service portal. Get the support you need when you need it with a dedicated service team you can email or call directly. The all-new TIPT with Webex gives your team the telephony and meeting functions they need wherever they choose to work.
Okay, thank you, Tim. Okay, so why Telstra for cloud calling? As I said, carrier-grade proven cloud platform. This has been around for 18 years. You're all currently running on it if you're a Telstra SIP Connect user, all right? If you're on SIP Connect attached to your PBXs, you are on this platform already. You know how reliable this platform has been over the years, all right? It is super robust, and nearly all of Telstra's business voice traffic runs on this platform. In fact, when we have migrated the remainder of the ISDN across, which will happen by May of 2022, so in about 6 months' time, every single piece of business voice traffic that is on, you know, that our customers are making is going over this platform. Okay, just to be clear, this is our core platform and it's carrier grade. The migration, as I said before, is risk-free because when we move you, we're not moving you to another box. We're moving you inside the platform. In fact, we're not even moving your number. If you actually look at what we're doing, we're adding capability, adding features and functionality to the telephone number that already lives there. And so by doing that, it means you don't need the PBX anymore, but it's all within the same platform. Really simple. And that's why it's completely risk-free, this migration, because you can roll it back too if you want to. There's a really broad ecosystem. This is the other key point, all right, that people struggle with. They've had these PBXs around for years and they've got a myriad of things connected to them. They may have, you know, a lot of analog devices. They may have boom gate lifters, door openers, public address systems. They have connected a myriad of things to these over time. You can do all of that with TIPT. You know, we as part of the platform, we offer standard handsets that you can buy from us, such as Poly handsets, Polycom, as they used to be known, Cisco handsets. We have Panasonic DECT handsets. We have IADs, devices for connecting analog phones in, like fax machines or cordless analog phones. We have a couple of those from Cisco and OneAxis. We've got a fair few vendors there. But if you decide that you want to go and buy, you know, off the internet, some boomgate lifter, you know, intercom system or something, as long as it can be programmed to work with SIP, you should be able to get it working with TIPT. We actually have specialized partners who will help you out. They have a range of phones and devices, exotic devices, we like to call them, that are, you know, waterproof or whatever, and they know exactly what parameters go where to make that work on TIPT. So we absolutely can give you a hand with that, and you can plug in pretty much anything that's SIP compatible. Anything that's not SIP compatible, you can then plug in via an analog adapter, an IAD. Also on the ecosystem, I talked about some APIs just now. There's a really broad range of APIs that let you do a whole lot of stuff. We can send you push notifications when you're about to receive a call. When you've made a call, you can check the status of something, which means you're going to be able to do some really clever things that you just cannot do when you have an on-site, on-premise PBX. Self-service portal. We have something called the Unified Communication Self-Service Portal. It's a long mouthful. So it's the UC Self-Service Portal or the UCSS. So you'll probably hear one of the two of us saying UCSS because we're so used to it, but it's the UC Self-Service Portal. That is a customer-facing portal, or one of our partners can use it as well on your behalf. In fact, Telstra staff can use it too. It allows you to do rapid changes, and the guys will talk about that as we go through, but that was a complete game changer for us this year. Getting stuff done in real time without having to, you know, put an order into Telstra and wait a few weeks for something to happen. Real time provisioning. Lastly, why go to Telstra for cloud calling? Well, you may think, well, Telstra, you know, you're probably going to be expensive, right? No, we've actually got a really simple model and it's really affordable. And I'm going to give you the example right now. Most of our customers take the TIPT standard pack. We have three main user packs. The standard pack's the middle one. They all pick the middle one, of course. It's $14 per month. That's the IRP price for it. Most of our customers then also add on a $10 unlimited calling plan, which means they can make unlimited local, national, fixed to mobile calls. Total cost, $24 per month. So you can easily work out, well, if I've got a site with 10 users, 10 times 24 is $240 a month. That covers everything. That is your, you know, that's your line rental, that is your calls, and that's your maintenance in the cloud. So you can turn off the SIP trunk, you don't pay for calls at the site anymore, and you can stop paying for PBX maintenance or upgrades that you don't need anymore. So really simple, affordable cost model. Right, I've done enough about why. I want the guys to talk you through the what and why, you know, how you can make this work in your business. So first up, we have Brad, and he's gonna talk about how the connectivity works. Over to you, Brad.
Thanks, Paul, and afternoon, everybody. And thanks, Tim. Going backwards. So connectivity made easy. We've spent a lot of time over the last couple of years enabling all of the features that are available on the platform to be accessed from anywhere, whether that's working from home, in the office, on the road, whatever it might be, and any of the devices accessible either over a private MPLS connection or over the internet, or obviously if you're using features like SD-WAN. So that could be, you know, the soft clients, an IP handset. I can have that working at home. So I've always had a lot of people do that in the last 18 months, pick up handsets, take them home and have those functioning in their home office. Could also be obviously our Liberate mobiles we're talking about, which we'll talk about a little bit more. And obviously all our collaboration tools, all able to access those core TIPT functions of things like hunt groups, call centers, auto attendants, music on hold, all functioning wherever you are. So it doesn't really matter where you are in the country. You can access all those resources as long as you've got an available network connectivity. Thanks, Tim. Get a bit of backing music. So it's all about that simple cloud management from anywhere. So Paul touched on the self-serve portal, which is obviously the first point there. And that's really been a game changer in allowing our customers and partners to make rapid changes on the platform. So where you've got a new starter coming along, you can see there in the image, all I need to do is go in there, put in their name, pick a phone number, what pack, and pick a handset, hit apply. That's then going to create that user on the fly, basically, send you an email back with their credentials so they can go and log on immediately to the soft client. If you've actually ordered a handset, then that basically gets drop shipped straight out, and typically they're arriving within 4 to 5 days. And then the credentials are there for you to enter into that handset and get that handset up and working as well. So really speedy, instantaneous response. And that portal does a whole load of other things other than just allow you to order new users. You can obviously add additional licensing on. So if you wanted to upgrade a user from a normal user to a call center user, which is something we've seen a lot done over the last year as well, where they're taking those call flows out of the office, sending them home, and we need that call center capability to be able to queue those calls and provide that experience for customers calling in. I can also order new hardware, headsets, power packs, all those sorts of things that you'd want to be able to order on there. And also those calling plans that Paul was mentioning before, they can be activated through the portal as well. So it's really trying to put the experience of ordering new services in the customer's hands and doing that, you know, instantaneously. Second to that, there's the actual TIPT administration portal. That allows you to go in there and administer all the functions and services that you have within the TIPT environment, whether that's a user, a hunt group, call centers, you know, my music on hold, all of those things can be admin from within that portal. So we don't restrict you from having administrative access to be able to perform all those functions. So you don't have to send us an email to go and do a simple update, like change the name on a user who's, you know, taken over someone's phone, or add another person into a hunt group, or even create a new hunt group or an auto attendant to, you know, address an urgent need. Thanks, Tim. So Paul's mentioned Liberate, and Liberate's a bit of a game changer for us. So we're the only carrier in Australia that actually has this capability, and one of the few in the world that has done this really tight integration between our mobile network and our UC platform being TIPT. So what does that mean? It really means turning your mobile into basically like a TIPT endpoint. So all of those features and functions that you would expect to work on a desk phone now work on your mobile. So it's about putting that fixed number onto your actual SIM. So rather than running an app and a VoIP app on the phone, all this is working off the native regular mobile voice call. So once I've liberated my phone, I can actually make an outbound call and send out my O2 number, so my actual desk phone identity. So that can ensure that I'm actually sending out the business identity and perhaps not my mobile identity, particularly if you're the sort of organization that lets your staff take their mobile number out the door when they walk out the door. You obviously don't want that IP going out the door with them in terms of that identity of that number. So keeping the O2 number on the phone means that that stays with the business and can be given to the next person that takes over that role. It's really simple to use because you're basically just using the normal dialer that's on the mobile. All that intelligence and control is being done up in the core of the network, and we're just manipulating that information that's on that call as it comes in and out to that user. It also means they can be part of all those things you would normally be part of in the office. So things like a hunt group or a call center. And that information is pushed out to that user when the call comes in. So as the call comes through to me, if I was in a hunt group, for example, it's actually going to send out the name of that hunt group to that user. So if I was in the service hunt group, as the call comes through to my mobile, as it would to my desk phone, it's going to display, you know, service queue, for example. So I can look at that and perhaps answer that call in a slightly different way than I would if it was just somebody direct to my mobile. It extends some pretty cool features out to the mobile that you typically don't have on a mobile as well. So one of those is pretty key, and we've seen customers actually move their entire branch environments to running purely off mobiles and using Liberate. Because one of the things that we do give with Liberate is the ability to transfer a call. Now, we do give you a little companion app that comes with Liberate that allows you to do that call control and signal the platform to tell it to do something for you. And one of those things is transfer a call, which you normally can't do on a mobile. On a mobile, you can only conference. Liberate allows you to emulate what you would normally do with a desk phone. So in a branch environment, if I've answered the call through the hunt group and it's not for me, it's actually for Eric, I can actually get Eric on the phone, do a consultative transfer, so a warm transfer. G'day, Eric. I've got Tim on the phone for you, and transfer that call off my mobile, freeing me up to make another call. Paul mentioned before, there's some pretty cool APIs, which he's going to go through at the end, so I won't talk too much about it. But you can obviously add things like call recording onto this and do some really cool things around who's actually, making those calls and able to record those calls. So putting together, whitelists around time of day, who's going to be recorded, all of those sorts of things can be driven via those APIs. And we've got customers doing that today. So that's all I want to cover off. Over to you, Eric. And I think you're going to chat more about a few of those features.
Thanks, Brad. I'll tell you, Liberate, that absolutely does change the game. Being able to operate all of those group features like hunt groups and call centers via a native mobile, I think is pretty awesome. I had one the other day using the call whisper feature, for example, so it even whispers the call, the hunt or the call center name in your ear as you answer the phones. Awesome stuff. Now, if you're coming off a PBX, you obviously want to have PBX features, right? And one of the things we're finding, or the feedback we get from some customers moving onto very different cloud platforms, is the fact that there's totally different terminology and there's quite complex admin to manage. TIPT certainly gives you, as you saw from Tim, or heard from Tim and Brad, that TIPT is a very, very simple platform to manage. And of course, you not only want all those standard PBX features that you're currently enjoying, like the hunt groups, busy landfills and call parks, you also want all the new stuff, all the current stuff, like video, mobile integration, as you heard from Brad, call recording in the cloud, even your users out in the field, in their cars or at home or in a cafe, maybe you need call recording. Maybe you need to spin up a call center within a week because you've got some new business spinning up. You can do all that through TIPT in the cloud. Makes it really, really simple. So all in all, you're getting all those standard PBX features that you're used to, plus more. We're not asking you to change to a completely different platform with completely different terminology and features. Now with TIPT, your users are going to have access to a very good soft client as well that'll allow them to log in with single sign-on. So that means they're logging into the application via their email address and their LAN password. So that's good. And not only that, that soft client will integrate into applications on the desktop, which I'm going to cover off in a minute, and things like presence. What about your receptionist? Now, receptionists are actually going to love TIPT because the My Reception console, which is an option with TIPT, gives receptionists the ultimate visibility of everybody in the organization nationally. So they'll be able to see when anybody is on the phone or their phone's ringing anywhere in the organization and be able to move calls around quickly and easily with the flick of a mouse. So that's pretty awesome. So we know receptionists absolutely love TIPT. And of course, if you want to get some reporting and analytics on your inbound calls for your organization, now who doesn't want visibility of all the calls coming in to their organization? So business intelligence, right? So be able to manage how you staff your inbound call reception or call center. Reporting, visibility, et cetera, you get all of that with TIPT. The TIPT call center is an option, of course, but it will give you that sort of reporting and functionality. And don't forget, as Paul said at the beginning, the analog devices are a requirement from a lot of customers, being able to plug in standard devices non-standard devices like, customized equipment, for example, generic SIP analog devices. Many cloud platforms that are available don't support those types of devices. So please be aware of that and have a look at exactly what you're using currently. Next slide. Now, I'm going to talk a bit about the soft client because of course, with many of you, our customers, working in a hybrid environment now, you've got your users working from home, from work, from cafes, if you're lucky. And so the soft client's really important. Now, of course, if you're using Liberate, as Brad talked about, you're not going to need a soft client because that's the ultimate soft client. It's the number on the SIM, right? But of course, if you're going to use a soft client, it's got to be easy to use. It's got to give you access to all your calling features so that users can get to everything really simply, require minimal training, be able to log in if they when the users log in to that soft client. We want SSO so they can log in with their email address and LAN password, of course. And we want that client to integrate with applications on the local machine like Microsoft Teams. I saw some questions on the chat from a customer saying, hey, you know, what's the difference between TIPT and Microsoft Teams? There's a very big difference. They're completely different products and have different functionality, different terminologies. TIPT is your, has more of your traditional PBX feature set, plus all of the new stuff that you would expect from a cloud platform. Whereas Microsoft Teams is are quite different from a calling perspective. So what we've done is we've launched this new soft client, which allows you to use TIPT, so to have all of that great functionality and migration capability from SIP risk-free, but utilize it with your users or have your users consume it with Microsoft Teams on their desktop. So we'd love to show you more of that. And that soft client, by the way, is called Webex. Next slide. So I'm just going to talk a little about that because I know a lot of our customers are saying, hang on a minute, Microsoft Teams, I thought you were talking about TIPT. TIPT does integrate with Microsoft Teams. So you as a customer have a choice. You don't have to use Microsoft phone system. If you do want to use it, we would love to sell it to you, but you don't have to. It's your choice. And so now you have a choice with TIPT with the all new Webex soft client. So you, in other words, your users can click to call, PSDN call from Microsoft Teams directly. So if you want all those enterprise calling features that TIPT offers, as we've spoken about, and you use Microsoft Teams on the desktop, this is your choice. Now let's have a look at what it looks like. I recorded a quick demo. Next slide.
Hi, my name is Eric Smith, and I'm just going to give you a quick demonstration of TIPT with Webex integrated for PSDN calling with Microsoft Teams. I've installed the Webex app. It's here on the right, and I've logged in with my SSO credentials, so it was nice and simple. Now I'm going to get rid of that application, minimize, hit the X. In Microsoft Teams, I've installed an app called Webex Call. That's via the App Store within Microsoft Teams, or it can be managed by the administrator. So now for the demo, I'm chatting away to David here, and I can see David's offline, so there's no point calling David via the usual Microsoft Teams icons. What I can do is via the icon down the bottom here, Webex Call, I can PSDN call David or anybody else I'm chatting with. When I click that button, what it's doing is it's looking up David's phone numbers via the Active Directory. I'm gonna select mobile and call, and I'm gonna answer that on my other phone over here. So now once I'm in a call, I've got all the usual mid-call controls, keypad, I've got conference, transfer, park and hold. So everything you need for PSDN calling. I'm just gonna kill that. Now, what if I need to get to a keypad? The icon here on the left gives me access to search the directory directly from here, or search from here, or type a phone number and call. So all the features that you need, and speed dials. I can set up my own speed dials. So for example, if I select Eric to speed dial, it's gonna try and call Eric. Simple as that. Now, what if I'm chatting away to somebody and a call comes in? What does that look like? You can see the toast pop up, click answer, and now I'm in a call. Nice and simple. PSDN calling with Microsoft Teams using TIPT with Webex.
It's so weird listening to your own voice on a demo, I've got to say. So, but look, I tell you, I hope you're as excited as I am, because as you saw from that demo, the new TIPT soft client integrates with Microsoft Teams. Now, absolutely, if you're not using Microsoft Teams and you want a premium messaging and meetings solution, that can be very easily clipped on to Webex, and we might cover that off later. So I hope you liked what you saw. Over to you, Tim.
Thanks, Eric. And yeah, I agree with you. It's hard listening to your own voice on a demonstration. But look, I think someone can, Sam, can you turn my video on, please? And I suppose what you've heard with Brad and with Eric now is obviously a full comprehensive cloud PBX solution. Now, I suppose I get the best part is I get to tell you how to do this. And we've kind of touched on the UC self-service portal or the UCSS or the Unified Communication Self-Service Portal that Paul pointed out at the start, right? That does all the migration for you. And it is completely risk-free. There's no involvement from a Telstra project manager or a Telstra account manager. This can be completely done by yourself or with your Telstra partner. It has full rollback capability. So within 14 days of placing your first order, you do have full rollback capability, not just once, not twice, as many times as you'd like within that period as well. You can migrate a single service or you can migrate the whole site in one go. And you do it when you're ready, not when Telstra's ready or, you know, within business hours. You can do this out of hours. You do it when you're ready. And it's completely controlled by yourself or the Telstra partner via the UC self-service portal. And once those services are activated, you can simply go and activate or add on the Webex soft client or their expose the meeting ability or activate Liberate on those Telstra mobile services that you have. I'll give you a real life example. The Adelaide Crows. So back on, I think, 10th of August, we launched this capability into the UC self-service portal and we gave a presentation to a whole bunch of customers. And the Adelaide Crows actually came to the session. They had an aging PBX system, but a PBX that still worked, but it had limitations with the current environment that we're in today with, you know, the COVID period. They had no ability to work from home, right? They had no soft clients. So when we all got sent home, their business stopped, right? Not only that, is when the members were also calling in to do their renewals or check on when the renewals are going to happen, they had to leave a voicemail. And that voicemail was then picked up by an agent and called back. So there was no live interaction, right? And also the organization had no visibility of what the agents or how many calls or, you know, what the organization's actually doing from a telephony point of view. So what was the solution? I suppose the solution here is the Telstra's IP telephony platform or TIPT. We enabled the Webex soft client for them. That's available on their PCs, laptops, Android devices and tablets. We turned on the call center feature. So now they see live queuing of their customers or their members coming into their queues. And agents able to speak to them right then and there. And it also gives the organization detailed reporting to see the progress of each agent throughout the week. Now, how quickly can this be done, right? That's the question. We had to do this. We had a very, very tight short time frame because you can imagine now the AFL, all the AFL clubs around Australia are going through a member renewal period. So we had a tight timeline. We did it in 14 days via the UC self-service portal and the Telstra partner. We placed the order on day one and 4 days later, the hardware was delivered. On day 10, the Telstra partner installed the handsets, right? So we're talking 10 days to get handsets installed onto the service. On day 13, we tested a single service from their PBX over to TIPT to make sure that one, their network connectivity, carriage and their TIPT handsets were working and we rolled the service back. And then day 14, the day after, we rolled the whole entire site over in minutes. Again, when the customer wanted to. So in 14 days, we picked up their whole old environment, their PBX that was inflexible with their current working arrangements, and we moved them over to the current, you know, day where we can flexibly work from anywhere. As long as work's being done, we can work from anywhere now. Our members are being spoken to agents in live time, and now we're able to see and the progress on our members are calling in at a, you know, when we send emails out and making sure that they're you know, they're calling in to do those renewals. 14 days this was done by the UC self-service portal, so it was pretty impressive. So I'm going to hand over to Paul, who's going to talk a little bit more about Liberate, but more specifically how it integrates into the mobiles.
Thank you, Tim. And so I have managed to turn my video back on. Unfortunately, Tim, you were without video there. I was because you did your best work on mute, but you weren't on mute, but you were on audio. So it's the modern equivalent, isn't it? Anyway, this is the last section, so hang on in there. Integrating the mobile phone call with your business application. So I wanted to talk to you about this because this is something we built for the there's Tim, nice shiny face. This is something we built for our Vantage event last month, beginning of October. And I wanted to give you a sense of this because this is really game changing. So this takes what we built with Liberate, but it extends it to APIs. I know a few of you have asked questions in on the chat around APIs. I have to be clear up front, it's not just about mobile integration. It actually works with TIPT. If you've got a TIPT handset on a desk, the same thing happens. So those APIs could be used for, I don't know, giving you your own personalized wall board from the TIPT call center, because we give you a standard generic one. If you don't like it and you want crazy colors and big text on a massive screen, build it yourself. There's an API to let you do it, all right? Or you can get a friendly partner to do it. We have plenty of those who have built those sorts of things. But what I really want to touch on with this is the mobile phone piece, because this is something that your existing PBX has no chance of doing, because we are linking in the APIs that work with Liberate, the mobile attached to your TIPT service. Okay, so I've got three examples I'm going to go through. The first one is around CRM integration, customer relationship management integration. So, you know, some well-known examples would be Salesforce.com, for instance, and Telstra uses that one internally. Or it could be Microsoft Dynamics, or a plethora of ones that are probably more bespoke for certain industries. Okay, so CRM. The second one we're going to go through is something we call call steering. That's the ability to actually change the direction of a call mid-call. So think about, you know, a call's heading to one of your employees, but actually you don't want one of your employees to have that call. You want to send it back to a call center. You intercept based on the phone number, based on time of day, direct it back. I'll show you that in a minute. And call identity management. That's where we can actually change the CLI. So you can actually hide the employee's number without doing an anonymous call that no one's ever going to answer. So in order to best show this, we built some animations, because this is a really hard topic to describe if you can't see it in action. So we've got three animations we're going to go through. They're all really short. They're only just over a minute each. So the first one we're going to go through is the CRM integration. Tim, if you can click to the next slide, please.
Telstra's CRM integration solution helps businesses match mobile phone calls in real time with customer contact information. You can capture more customer interactions and give customers a better experience. When one of your customers calls one of your frontline staff, like a technician in the field who has a Telstra mobile, a functionality called Liberate detects the call. Liberate can talk to your CRM system by sending a push notification with both callers' numbers. The CRM then matches the customer and the technician's number and can then trigger the technician's laptop to open the customer's contact card. When your technician answers the call, the customer's contact card is already available on their laptop. This allows the customer's issue to...
Did that finish early, Tim? No, it was almost at the end anyway, but the last bit, the customer's issue to be dealt with, and the fact that you could then see what was going on across the company, right? Because someone else in the company could then see what the technician had done. Just to give you some ideas around that one, that was a technician example, but think about a salesperson example. I always use that one. Think about the fact that most salespeople these days, certainly ours do, tend to use their mobile phones for calling their customers, and their customers call them back on their mobile phones. Now, if they were doing it to the office on a TIPT phone, yes, we could do it there, and a lot of other systems would have had something in the past called computer telephony integration, CTI. But think about the mobile example. If someone's ringing a mobile, that's an island normally that is just not attached to anything. How would you make that work? And even on the Telstra network, the mobile network itself does not have any APIs apart from a messaging API. There are no APIs on our mobile network, and neither do any of the other carriers. Because we've linked our UC platform, all right, our TIPT network, our TIPT platform, to the mobile network, we've tied the two together. We essentially, as Brad said, made that mobile become a TIPT endpoint. And once it became a TIPT endpoint, we have APIs that work. We know when it's about to receive a call and who's calling it. So in that example, you're about to receive a call and your phone may be ringing. You can see on your call, you know, who's ringing you, obviously, if it's one of your customers, if you're an account manager. But at the same time, in the background, your laptop is actually bringing up the contact card ready for you to fill it in. So, you know, it could be that, you know, from a Salesforce point of view, that just gives you better hygiene of the CRM system, right? It forces, not forces, but it encourages your person answering the call to actually type in the details in the CRM system of what the call was about. Because the next time that customer rings in and maybe talks to someone else, someone can look at the CRM and go, oh, they just talked to John only yesterday about this. And so that's why it's so powerful. Or, and again, the, you know, the example with the technician there, the technician's updated their part of the job. Someone else may need to do the next part. Okay. So that was CRM. Now we're going to go to call steering, where we're going to say, have the same technician you'll see in this video or animation, but this time, because they're really busy and you'll see they're on the tools, all right, we don't want them taking calls unless it's from a specific person. It could be, you know, we don't want them taking calls from internal staff, but we don't want them taking calls from external staff, maybe in a certain time window. So if you can play this one, Tim, please.
Telstra's call steering solution helps improve communication flows and make your business more efficient. When one of your customers calls one of your frontline staff, like a technician in the field who has a Telstra mobile, a functionality called Liberate detects the call. Liberate can send a push notification to your database to check if the customer's mobile number is allowed to call the technician directly at this time. Perhaps the call might not be permitted because your rostering blocks out dedicated hours for completing work, or the call is not from one of your premium customers. If the call isn't allowed at this time, you can redirect the call to another number, like your call center. This can happen in real time before the technician's mobile even rings. A customer service rep answers the call, and the customer doesn't have to leave a voicemail or wait for a callback. Your technician can carry on with their work without interruptions. A callback notification is sent to the technician's calendar so they can call back when convenient. With call steering, you're more in control of your communication flows. Give your customers a better experience with Telstra Call Steering today. For more information, visit telstra.com/liberate.
Thank you, Tim. And while I'm there, that telstra.com/liberate is where you'll find those animations. So if you want to show other people, you know, you've been on this call today and you want to explain it to someone else in your organization, just go to telstra.com/liberate. Those three animations are about a third of the way down the page. You can replay them whenever you want. So let me just talk quickly to that one. So you think about that, right? Someone has dialed your technician's mobile number. Again, that's not normally linked to your PBX. There's no way you can do anything with that in a normal scenario. It would go straight to them. Because of what we've done with Liberate, because there's an API available, we can intercept that call and divert it to a call center before the mobile even rings in most instances, right? So that technician doesn't even know the mobile was about to ring. Let me give you another sales example, because we've actually delivered this. This is a real example. We just changed it around to a technician. It was another sales example for a customer. They'd shrunk their sales force. And so their remaining account managers, who were only meant to be dealing with the real top end accounts, were getting calls from a lot of smaller accounts who still had their mobile numbers. So they put this solution in place. And they essentially, what they did is they whitelisted all of the top account phone numbers, so that they called them, the call went through to the account manager as per normal. But if it was from someone else or someone who wasn't internal to the customer organization themselves, sorry, the actual organization, what happened was it looked the number up, went not allowed, sent it to the call center. So that, because the call center was set up to deal with the smaller customers, they're the ones who are capturing the information, the CRM, and logging the jobs or logging the orders or whatever. So it's a beautiful way of actually making sure that the call goes to the right person, and gives you a real boost in efficiency and effectiveness of that employee. All right. So the last one we're going to come to is call management. And this one's important because in the last two examples, if you were watching carefully, the customer always dialed the technician's mobile number. And that's because they had the mobile number already. They knew what it was. So how do you prevent it in the first place and stop them actually finding out what the technician's mobile number is? How do you get the technician, when they make a call, to present an actual business number, maybe the main number that gets answered via the call center or something, so that, you know, it gives a more professional look when they're calling out and stops them getting the random callbacks, all right? So let's play this one, Tim.
Mm-hmm. Telstra's call management solution helps improve communication flows and make your business more efficient. With hybrid working, many employees are using their mobile phones for business calls. That's why we developed Liberate, a solution to manage your employees' identity when calling from their mobile phone. With Liberate, employees calling from Telstra mobiles can choose to present either their mobile number or their business number to the person that they are calling. When your worker makes a call via their Telstra mobile, Liberate checks their stored preferences and shows either their business number or their mobile number, depending on the day of the week or the time of day. This gives your workers control of their mobile identity and allows them to separate their work and personal calls more easily, all on the same mobile phone. And the boosted efficiency creates more time for your employees to focus on what they do best, whilst projecting a more professional and consistent business image to their customers. It also encourages your customers to always call the business number to get the best service. For more information, visit telstra.com/liberate.
Thanks, Tim. So you can see that would be an ideal solution for a frontline worker. You know, it could be a tradie, all right, or it could be a police officer. Anyone who's out and about dealing with members of the public, getting calls where you may want to let some through, not let some through, but at different times of day. So all three of those are ones that have been done already, by the way. They're not, we haven't just made them up. These are based on real examples. We have partners and we also have Telstra Purple that can do this. So depending on whether you want to use the Telstra Purple resources with inside Telstra to build a solution for you, or you want to go through one of our partners, we have done all this already, right? We have done multiple CRM integrations. As I said before, we've done like accounting system integrations like Xero, for those of you, Xero, into that type of platform. The call steering has, that account manager example was real. That's the one I gave you, right? So all of this, if you want those animations, are on the telstra.com/liberate website. But also there's a fourth one on there, which we haven't covered today, but just give you the quick highlights, which is a time-sheeting one. So if you need people to track the time they spend calling your customers or taking calls from your customers, so again, it could be a technician, could be where the customer's bought 10 hours worth of tech time. And so you want to count down the 10 hours until they run out of time, right? So you can use a time cheating one, right? Every time they make or receive a call from a customer, we can send that as a push notification, you know, on their mobile, push notification to your platform. You can decrement the hours left to get down to zero. Guess what? You then use the call steering application to block the very next call from the customer and actually send it to your call center so they can top up their credit and get another 10 hours worth. So you can combine these scenarios, all right? So really powerful. The one you'll see on our website is a company called MyTimes. They did initially one for lawyers. So again, you can imagine a lawyer about to run into court, takes a quick call on his mobile from a client, not the one he's about to deal with, spends 5 minutes telling them what to do, has to go, he's gonna run into court, gets back to the office later, forgets to write it down and never bills it. Not with this solution. They get back to their desk, it's on their timesheet already. You had a 5 minute call with your client at 9:36 a.m. Bill, yes or no? And they press yes. And you'll see there's a really good return on investment for that in terms of just actually billing and capturing time that would otherwise not have been captured and we would have been revenue generating. Okay. Right. That's got through that a lot. I think we're now at questions and we have been asked, answering a whole load in the chat. I will ask the guys, because I've been talking for the last few minutes, were there any common themes there or anything we promised to answer in the chat that we haven't yet answered? Anyone want to give me anything that needs talking about? Otherwise, and we did what we did, by the way, we were quite clever here. We have some canned questions because we figured just in case anyone doesn't ask any questions, which actually you guys asked a lot, but we do have a couple of questions which expand on the Webex bit, which is this one here, and the call recording bit. We usually get a lot of call questions around call recording. So if we don't have any that urgently need answering right now. Quick, Eric, look, a question's just come in that we pre-prepared and is ready on the screen now. What else can you do with Webex?
Look, it's a good question because and I'm surprised there have been more questions. What's that, mate?
This is a great question because we wrote it.
Yes, that's right. Yeah. Most customers say to us, so this new soft client on TIPT called Webex, isn't Webex a meetings app? Well, yeah, Webex is meetings, but you saw the demonstration I gave you. You can run Webex in calling only mode, which is awesome. And in fact, that demo I showed you with the client running integrated with Microsoft Teams, that comes with TIPT. So you heard Paul talk about the pricing up front and give some examples. That soft client and that Microsoft integration is just included as a default with TIPT. But if you want to add Webex messaging, so you're not using Microsoft Teams or you're not using Slack, it's a $1 clip-on. And that is so simple and easy and very, very cost effective. And that's enterprise messaging and spaces, et cetera, you know, to manage your teams, et cetera, or teams messaging. And for a $10 clip-on, you get full Webex meetings. So Webex can be just calling, it can be messaging, and it can be meetings.
Fantastic. Thank you, Eric. And another question from that we wrote ourselves, let's face it. Client call recording. Brad, you'll have to turn your video back on and unmute yourself if you're still there because I can't see you.
Sorry, busy typing.
Yes, I know. And that's why we turned the video off, because we're also busy typing. We looked like we weren't interested, so we thought, oh, we'll turn the video off. But that shot ourselves in the foot, so we won't do that again. Brad.
Yeah, thanks, Paul. Look, call recording is quite a cool feature on the TIPT environment, because we actually capture that call and record it out of the core of the network. So it doesn't really matter whether you're on a desk phone in the office, a soft phone at home, or a Liberate mobile on the go, we can record any of those calls regardless of where that person is, which is quite unique. You know, generally on a PBX, you need that call to actually be routing through the PBX to be able to record that call. So if you've got people out on mobiles, that becomes a real challenge. We've got quite a lot of customers that are looking at doing this at the moment for regulatory and compliance reasons, but also a lot of people looking to do it these days to use the built-in analytics that some of these recording platforms have to understand customer sentiment and, you know, all that sort of stuff to drive up happiness within your customer base and understand, you know, what's going on amongst your teams that are actually answering those calls. Is your customer happy? They're not happy? Is it different days of the week? Is it different people? You know, analyzing and using those analytics to assess those trends. And as I mentioned before, using those APIs to integrate with that as well, around being able to dictate, well, maybe I only want recording turned on from 9 to 5, and then after that I want it turned off, or there's a specific set of numbers that I don't want to record, but any other number I want to record, or the other way around, I want to record certain numbers and not record anything else. So a lot of powerful capabilities there around that recording, and we're only seeing, you know, an increase in customers requiring that sort of recording capability for those compliance reasons, or, you know, customer analytics, or it could be even just as simple as, you know, being able to play back and understand who said what in a conversation, where we've certainly had customers looking at that where, you know, you got people dialing in and ordering, for example, large quantities of concrete, and then people dialing up later and arguing the toss over whether they ordered too much, not enough, or whatever it might be for some of our customers out there. So just a few examples around cloud call recording. Thanks, Paul.
Thank you. And we do, so in terms of those where that recording box is on the right-hand side, the ones at the moment attached to our platform are Dubber, so that's quite a well-known one, and also Call N, which we did onboard separately, but then got bought by Dubber. So we will add more potentially, but you can certainly have this call recording ability right now. And as Brad said, the key here is, again, we're the only carrier who can do this in the network. Every other form of call recording on a mobile requires it to be sent through, the call to be sent through something else, right? Like a separate box or be done on an app. This is natively out of the network on a normal mobile phone call where no manipulation has taken place. Okay.
All right. Just a question there, Paul, about can you use TIPT on any other internet service? And the answer is yes, you can certainly use it across any internet service. You're going to get a premium experience, obviously, if you run that across Telstra internet. Because you're going to have shorter hops, but we also actually have a lot more session border controllers attached to our own network. So you're going to get a shorter path to our platform than what you will across competitors, but absolutely it works over any general internet.
Perfect. I did see one other question as I was looking at questions, and there's a whole load gone by now, which is great. Around, I think it was migrating off of they're using an SBC to hook into Microsoft Teams or something. I don't know if we answered that one in the chat, but that was that SIP Connect to TIPT migration that Tim mentioned or talked about. So as long as you're on SIP Connect, you have the same ability as the Adelaide Crows did. So it doesn't really matter. As long as you're on SIP Connect, that's the key, that it can be done. What I do realize is, Go on, Tim, you're about to say something?
Yeah, I was just, there was one here as well around, can I order additional handsets at any time as long as the TIPT group is complete? The UC self-service portal doesn't govern you by how many handsets you want to buy. So if you want to buy an extra 20 handset, go for it. And you know, you don't have to buy user packs at that time. We do have a separate section in the UC self-service portal where you can buy headsets and handsets individually from the users. So we've kind of thought about that in the UC self-service portal too.
Okay, there's a
question there. Can we use any IP phones? I guess as Paul mentioned, you can attach in general any SIP device. However, we do have accredited devices that we use on the platform, being Polycom and Cisco devices. They obviously have a full support in terms of configuration, firmware, and deployment. So if you're doing a large deployment, our recommendation would be you go with those devices because it is much simpler than having to log into each device and go into its GUI and manually configure every single setting in there. But certainly if you've got any, you know, bespoke things that Paul was talking about, you know, odds and sods here and there, then you'd certainly attach those. But for your general, you know, bulk deployments, we'd recommend you go with the Cisco and the Polys because they're fully supported on the platform.
Right. And the Panasonic, sorry, the Panasonic deck as well.
Yeah. True, and one access IDs. And,
Just a last one. Reach out to the mailbox as well for anyone that wants to, you know, have a conversation with us. For customers that want to, you know, demo the administration portal or anything like that, we're happy to do any of those demonstrations as well. So reach out to our mailbox, and one of us that's on the call here will do the demonstration for you.